Good afternoon, Stars. Today is Friday, April 15th. Let's check today's headlines.
Manson family member granted parole.
Reality store.
And golf team in action.
Thanks for joining us, Stars. I'm Daniel Collins.
And I'm Alex Holbrook. Let's go ahead and check the question of the day.
The question is, on this day in 1947, Major League Baseball integrated its first African-American player. Who was he?
Call Radio and TV extension 3132 if you think you know the answer. In today's top story, Leslie Van Houten, who participated in the Charles Manson-led murders of 1969, was recommended for parole on Thursday after nearly 50 years behind bars. A lawyer stated that Van Houten, now 66, presents no danger to the public and should be freed. Van Houten has spent more than four decades in prison for the killings of Lino LaBianca and his wife, which were orchestrated by none other than notorious criminal Charles Manson, who is currently in jail for life for his role in the killings. That's all for top story. Now back to Daniel.
April 29th is the last day to purchase a yearbook. They are $55 each. Please see Ms. Weber for more details and order form. Today, both 8th graders and seniors participated in a reality store in the main gym. It challenged them to decide what to do with their money under certain conditions. Students got to experience life as an adult firsthand by choosing a career of their choice within their GPA range. Us here at WBTV Newsroom would like to thank all the volunteers and teachers that helped make it possible.
Alex Martin is outside enjoying the sunshine. He'll have the forecast after we check today's Home National Bank community calendar.
Can't tell you what it really is. I can only tell you what it feels like. And right now it's a steel knife in my windpipe. I can't breathe, but I still fight. Well, I can fight. As long as the wrong feels right, it's like I'm in flight. High off a log, drunk from my hate. It's like I'm huffing pain. I love her, the more I suffer. I suffocate. Right before I'm about to drown, she resuscitates me. She freaking hates me. And I love it. Wait, where you going? I'm leaving you. No, you ain't come back. We're running right back. Here we go again. It's so insane.
And now Alex Martin joins us with weather from outside the studio. So Alex, I'm on my way to class. It was beautiful outside. Can you tell me a little bit about how it feels?
Well, I don't mean to brag, Daniel. It feels absolutely amazing out here right now. Let's take a look at our current conditions. So currently it's 68 degrees outside, not a cloud in sight, beautiful sunny skies. The winds are out of the south, pretty calm right now from where I'm standing at, and the pressure's at 30.2 and steady. Let's take a look at our almanac. Thank goodness I'm not in Silver Lake, Colorado, where they received 75.8 inches of snow in 24 hours back April 15th, 1921. Brr. Let's take a look at our surface map. Our surface map right now hasn't changed from the past few days because of this high pressure system that has just dominated this Midwestern region. Let's take a look at another surface map right here. This is going to show us earlier into next week, Monday and Tuesday, pretty much the same as our last surface map. But the main thing you need to realize right now is the jet stream that is way up above the northern United States right now into Canada. That's what's pushing that cold air north and keeping this nice warm air right here in the United States. Let's take a look at our 7-day forecast. Saturday and Sunday are pretty much the same with 74 degrees as their high, 50s in the low, and plenty of sunshine to go along for those 2 days. Monday's at 78. That's the highest we've been all year. Tuesday through Friday right now is going to be a high of 71 and a low in the 40s and 50s. The main thing we need to look out for right now, though, is that Thursday and Friday we have a high percentage of rain right now at 60%. That's all for weather. Now back to the news desk.
And now our sports director, Alex Holbrook, joins us with sports. So, Alex, the golf team was in action last night. Can you tell me about how that went?
Yeah, the golf team had a really good outing against Zionsville and Hamilton tonight, and we'll get to that in just a moment. And sports, the baseball and softball teams were back at it again last night as they took on Lebanon. The softball team was defeated in a lopsided affair, 11-1. The baseball team had close game against the Tigers. Your Stars had the bases loaded with one out in the seventh, but were unable to capitalize as they lost 5-4. The golf team was in action last night as they played Zionsville and Hamilton Heights. The Stars shot a 180 as a team and defeated Hamilton Heights, who shot a 207, but were defeated by Zionsville, who shot a 149. Leading for your Stars were Nick Wilson and Dalton Davis, who both shot 44s. The Stars will split into two teams for their next match tomorrow. The varsity team will travel to Danville, while the second team will travel to Covington. In NFL news, the Tennessee Titans have traded their first overall pick in the 2016 draft to the Los Angeles Rams. The Rams will receive the Titans' first, fourth, and sixth round selections in exchange for a multitude of current and future draft selections. The Rams were looking to make their first big splash since moving to Los Angeles. And this trade will ask the Rams to select their future quarterback, and whether it will be Jared Goff of California or Carson Wentz from North Dakota State remains to be seen. The 2016 NFL Draft will be held April 28th in Chicago. That's all for sports. Now back to Daniel for the answer to the question of the day.
Now let's check the answer to the question of the day. The question was, on this day in 1947, Major League Baseball integrated its first African-American player. Who was he?
If you answered Jackie Robinson, you are correct. Classes who answered correctly are Mrs. Alexander, Mr. Runny, Mr. Cunningham, Mrs. Lurch,
Mr. Vaughn, Ms. Weber, Mr. Riggins, and Mr. Schlemmer.
That's all for today's broadcast. Thank you for joining us. I'm Alex Holbrook.
And I'm Daniel Collins. Have a great weekend, Stars.
Keep spinning and yes, I turn myself into a solitary man. Ain't like I'm the only one
afternoon, Stars. Today is Monday, April 25th. Let's check today's headlines.
High school student killed.
Tennis fundraiser.
And makeup golf call out.
Thanks for joining us, Stars. I'm Courtney Alexander.
And I'm Paige Thomerson. Let's go ahead and check the question of the day.
The question is, how long is a marathon running race?
Call Radio and TV at extension 3132 if you think you know the answer. In today's top story, a 16-year-old sophomore from Delaware High School died on Thursday the 21st. Students said that a fight broke out inside the restroom where the several female students participated in the fight. The victim's name was Amy Francis Joyner. Police said that no weapons were involved and further questioning will be done. A student that was stuck in a stall when this fight occurred said that she hit her head on the sink after being hit by multiple students. Francis Joyner's father said that, "I think this is a dream and I'm trying to wake up." That is it for Top Story. Now back to Courtney.
The Weibo Tennis Program is hosting a fundraiser this Wednesday, May 27th at El Maison Restaurant in Lebanon. 10% of the day's total profit will go toward the Weibo Tennis Fund for a new equipment. Please tell friends and family and thanks for helping the Weibo Tennis Program.
Attention all girl golfers in the grades 8 through 11. If you missed the call-out meeting but are still interested in playing golf, please see Mrs. Gray for the schedule and more information. She will need to know if you plan on playing by May 18th. They will also be attending a camp this summer, and the camp fee and shirt deposit are also needed by May 18th.
Megan will have her forecast after we check today's Home National Bank community calendar. We'll be right back.
So, Megan, I heard there's pretty warm temperatures outside. Can we expect those to stay?
Yeah, those are expected to stick around, but we do have some rain in our forecast. Let's take a look at our weather shot brought to you by Drake Musselman. You can see outside that it is pretty windy. We have some cumulus clouds sticking in the sky. Let's take a look at our current conditions. Currently, it is 76 degrees outside and partly cloudy. Those winds are coming out of the southwest at 17 miles per hour. Looking at our current temperatures, around Indiana, it is pretty warm outside. Bloomington checking in at 78 and Champaign checking in at 81 degrees. Those temperatures are expected to dip down later on this week. Looking at our surface map, these thunderstorms are expected to move in, sticking around for a few days due to the stationary front, but eventually they will push off to the east coast. Looking at our 7-day forecast, you can see that rain come into play Wednesday and Thursday with an 80% chance of rain. And those temperatures, you can see they're going to dip down later on this week. That's all for weather. Now back to the news desk.
And now Alice Martin joins us with sports.
So what's been happening in Weibo sports lately?
Well, we were really busy this week in Corning. I'm going to tell you about that just right now. Western Boone Varsity Sports were busy this weekend. The girls' tennis team hosted the Weibo Invite on Saturday. The girls' stars opened up with a 5-0 win over Carroll, but lost a tough match to Fountain Central later on. Emma Schaefer and Meg Kinslow went undefeated in singles, and Kylie Dobbs and Katie Dale went undefeated in doubles. The stars are now 6-2 and open up conference play at Frankfurt tonight at 5 p.m. The varsity boys golf team was in action as well at Noblesville this weekend. Western Boone shot a 343 to finish 17th out of 24 teams. Caleb Vickery led the way with an 81, followed closely by Eli Weber with an 85. They take on Clinton Prairie and Sheridan tonight at Cool Lake. And finally, the boys and girls track team traveled the Speedway to compete in the Brad Pettigo Memorial Relays. Out of four teams, the stars won both boys and girls team competitions. Callie Gubero won the girls' high jump, and Alexis Goglio lowered her own school record in the mile to 5:36.6. The track team travels to Southmont to compete tomorrow against Lebanon and Southmont. Congratulations to all teams who competed this weekend. That's all for sports. Now back to Courtney and Paige for the answer to the question of the day.
Now let's check the answer to the question of the day. The question was, how long is a marathon running race?
If you answered 26.2, you are correct. The classes who answered correctly are
Mrs. Acton, Mrs. Alexander, Mr. Brunty, Mrs. Cornelius, Mr. Cunningham, Mr. Dale, Mrs. Foxworthy, Mrs. Lurch, Mr. Vaughn,
Miss Weber, Mr. Riggins, Mr. Schlimmer, and Mr. Tarhar. That's all for today's broadcast. Thank you for joining us. I'm Courtney Alexander.
I'm Megan Perry.
I'm Alex Martin.
And I'm Paige Thomerson. From all of us here at WBTV, have a great day. I can feel you
Six.
Maybe there's $1 billion in there. Let's go find out.
Come on, come on, come on! Think of all the money that could be in there.
It can't possibly be in there.
There could be money? I can't wait to see what's in this room.
Will you shut up already?
Come on, stop walking so slow.
Hey, I think we just passed his office. It's the other way.
Oh my god, what a mess. You can find a body in here.
I wonder what he did in here. Deborah! Deborah! Deborah!
Western Boone High School may look like any other Midwestern high school. You will find lockers, classrooms, and teachers teaching. But one thing that is new this year is the use of technology in the classroom.
With the implementations of laptops for the entire student body, the world of traditional textbooks may be soon going away forever.
But with new technology comes new challenges for the teachers and administrators. One of these challenges is the need for website restrictions, what's needed for school, and what's considered entertainment. Students have many different reactions to the current policy.
I feel like each student having their own laptop is really helpful because we get to keep all of our documents in one place and it's easier to turn in homework.
I think that the restrictions that the school has placed are for our protection and that they help us not get in trouble. But also it helps the learning atmosphere and for us to focus on our schoolwork versus other things that we could be doing.
And whether you agree or not with the restrictions, one thing you can't deny is that high-tech learning is here to stay, and adapting to these challenges are just some of the problems facing students and schools in the 21st century. For WBGV News, I'm Paige Thomerson.
Maybe I'm a dreamer. Maybe I'm misunderstood. Maybe you're not seeing the side of me you should. Maybe I'm crazy. Maybe I'm the only one. Maybe I'm just out of touch. Maybe I've just had enough. And maybe it's time to change and leave it all behind. I've never been one to walk alone. I've always been scared to try. So why does it feel so wrong to reach for something more? To wanna live a better life. What am I waiting for? 'Cause nothing stays the same. Maybe it's time to change. Maybe it's hopeless. Maybe it's hopeless. Maybe I should just give up. Maybe I should just give up. And what if I can't trust myself? What if I just need to live?